We start the new topic, projection of displacement, velocity and acceleration. Consider a particle P performing anticlockwise uniform circular motion. Angular position of particle P is decided with reference axis. Suppose this is a diagram. Here we consider GE is a reference line, or it is also known as x-axis. So particle starts from a point E. Suppose this red mark, nothing but a particle. We start moving in anticlockwise direction in this way. So when the particle is at a point E, so it does not make any angle with this reference line. So its angular displacement is zero. Now particle is at another point P0, which makes an angle phi with this reference line. This is called as angular position of a particle at point P0. After some time t, particle reaches to the new point as a point P. It displaces from P0 to P through an angle omega t. But its angular displacement is total of both these angles, that is omega t plus phi, gives you the angular displacement of a particle when it is at a point P. After some time it reaches at a point F. When it reaches at a point F, it makes an angle 90 degree with this reference line. This 90 degree is also known as pi by 2. So in this case, or at this position, angular displacement is pi by 2. If the particle now at a point G, so it covers total angle as pi or 180 degree, angular displacement of particle is 180. When particle is at a point H, so it covers 90 plus 90 and 90, that is a 270 degree angle. This 270 degree may be written as 3 pi by 2. This is the angular position when the particle is at point H. After completing the total rotation, when the particle reaches at point E, it covers a total 360 degree angle. It is also known as 2 pi, that is angular position of a particle when it is at E is 2 pi radian or 360 degree. We consider the particle is at point P. When particle is at point P, we calculate the projection of a displacement, projection of velocity and projection of acceleration. To calculate the displacement, we draw the perpendicular from P on this y-axis or diameter FH. So perpendicular from P touches on this y-axis at a point M. Distance of a point M from a origin, that is y, is known as projection of a displacement. This angle is theta. Naturally, this angle is also theta, and theta is equal to omega t plus phi. So this angle is also omega t plus phi. We apply here the trigonometric ratio as a sine theta. So this is a right angle triangle. PMO is right angle triangle. It makes here a 90 degree. Applying the sine theta. So sine theta to calculate projection of displacement, we apply the formula of sine theta. So sine theta is equal to opposite side, that is OM, divided by hypotenuse, that is OP. OP is nothing but a radius, so we substitute that value, and OM we consider to be a Y. So Y divided by R, shift R to the other side, so we get Y is equal to R sine theta, or substituting the value of theta, as omega t plus pi. This gives you the projection of a displacement. It is also known as equation of linear SHM. Y is equal to R sine omega t plus phi is equivalent to the linear equation of SHM as X is equal to A sine omega t plus phi. Here A gives you the amplitude. Similarly, in this case, R gives you the amplitude of a projection of a displacement. Now, we calculate the projection of velocity. So, we consider the similar figure for calculation of projection of velocity. This angle is theta, naturally this is also a theta. We draw the tangent at point P to this circular path. This tangent gives you the linear velocity of a particle at point P, which is V bar is equal to R omega. Perpendicular from P drawn on y axis, which touches the y axis at point M, we draw a parallel vector to the V bar, which is M, N, it is also V bar. From N, we draw the perpendicular on y axis, touches to y axis at a point L, so it makes an angle 90 degree at L. Again, we apply the trigonometric ratio to the triangle NLP. Use a cos value of trigonometry, that is cos theta is equal to adjacent side, that is LM, divided by hypotenuse, that is NM. But NM is parallel to the V bar, so NM is also V, and LM gives you the velocity. Linear velocity along y-axis we denote, that is Vy. So from that, Vy is equal to V cos of theta, but we know V is equal to R omega. Substitute that value, Vy is equal to R omega cos of theta. So theta is also omega t plus phi. Substituting the theta is equal to omega t plus phi, we get Vy is equal to R omega cos of inside bracket omega t plus phi. It gives you projection of velocity of a P on reference diameter. This is a reference diameter, or it is also called as a y axis. And last, calculate the projection of acceleration considering the again a similar figure, same figure. So we have drawn the perpendicular from point P on reference diameter, which touches on that reference diameter at point M. When the particle is at point P, the centripetal acceleration directed towards the center, it is ACP. Distance of a foot of perpendicular from origin is AY, that is a component of centripetal acceleration. AY, it is also known as projection of acceleration. Now we apply the sine trigonometry to the triangle PMO. So sine theta is again opposite side OM divided by hypotenuse, that is OP. OM is nothing but AY and OP is nothing but CP. From that, AY is equal to ACP sine inside bracket omega t plus phi by substituting the value of theta. But value of centripetal acceleration is minus r omega square. Substitute that in the equation. Minus r omega square sine omega t plus phi. Write r sine inside bracket omega t plus phi in a bracket, and it gives you the value of y that is a projection of a displacement. Therefore, Ay is equal to minus omega square y. It gives acceleration for linear SHM. Here, omega square is a constant. Naturally, Ay is proportional to the y, that is acceleration, projection of acceleration proportional to the displacement, and this is a condition of linear SHM. Therefore, projection of UCM on any diameter is an SHM. Phase of SHM, it gives the state of oscillation. To know state of oscillation, we require displacement, direction of velocity, and oscillation number at that instant of time. So to know the state of oscillation, that means position of a particle at a given time, we require the three terms, that is first displacement, second direction of velocity, and third number of oscillation performed by the body. Through which angle it is displaced, called as angular displacement, theta is equal to omega t plus phi. It is also known as phase angle. म्हणजे एखादी वस्तू ठराविक कालावधीनंतर कुठं आहे हे दाखवणारी जी काही टर्म आहे तिला म्हणलं जातं फेज ऑफ SHM, आणि ती अँगलच्या भाषेत दाखवली जाते त्यालाच म्हणलं जातं फेज अँगल. आणि हा फेज अँगल माहिती होण्यासाठी आपल्याला तीन गोष्टींची गरज पडते, एक डिस्प्लेसमेंट, दुसरं व्हेलॉसिटीची डायरेक्शन, दिशा, आणि त्याने किती ऑसोलेशन कम्प्लीट केले त्याच. सो फर्स्ट वी सी द व्हॉट इज द ऑसोलेशन. सपोज दिस इज अ diagram, draw this diagram properly, we required it while writing the explanation of phase of angle. Suppose particle P is at mean position, that is on x-axis, it start rotating in anticlockwise direction. This is known as a positive direction. When it covers an angle 90 degree, then it reaches at the point E, known as positive extreme position. Again it start moving in anticlockwise direction, reaches at a new point, as say the Q point. When it reaches at a point Q, that is it is at mean position, and it start moving again in anticlockwise direction, this cycle we say the negative cycle. When it covers an angle 270 degree, then which is at a negative extreme position. After completing one complete cycle, it reaches at a point P, that means it completed one oscillation, that means one oscillation completed, and it start moving with a second oscillation, that means it is starting off a second oscillation. We see the step by step. First step, when the phase angle is zero, that means particle is at a mean position. Here it does not make any angle with x-axis, that means theta is equal to zero. Particle is at mean position, moving to the positive direction, that means it is start moving towards the positive direction. It is the beginning of first oscillation. A पहिल्या ऑसोलेशनची ही सुरुवात. वेन द फेज अँगल इज 360, दॅट मीन्स इट कवर्स वन रोटेशन कम्प्लीटली अँड रिचेस ॲट अ पॉइंट पी अगेन, दॅट मीन्स इट कवर्स अ 360 अँड स्टार्ट मूव्हिंग इट. दिट इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ सेकंड सायकल. फेज अँगल थीटा इज इक्वल टू 360, पार्टिकल इज ॲट मीन पोझिशन, अँड इट इज अ बिगिनिंग ऑफ अ सेकंड ऑसोलेशन अँड सो ऑन. प्रत्येक वेळा 360 झालं की नवीन ऑसोलेशन तुमचं पुढचं सुरू होणार आहे. अज्युम दॅट इट इज अ फर्स्ट ऑसोलेशन अँड पार्टिकल रिचेस ॲट अ पॉइंट ई, दॅट इज बाय 90 डिग्री इट ट्रॅव्हल इन फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन, दॅट मीन्स पार्टिकल इज ॲट नाव पॉझिटिव्ह एक्स्ट्रीम पोझिशन इन अ फर्स्ट अँगल, अँड ॲट दॅट केस युअर फेज अँगल is theta is equal to 90 degree, or it is also known as pi by 2. During first oscillation, particle is at positive extreme position. When the particle completed one oscillation and covers 90 degree, at that case phase angle theta is equal to first oscillation it covers 360, then 90. So 360 plus 90, it is also known as 2 pi plus pi by 2 radian. During second oscillation, particle is at positive extreme position. म्हणजे पार्टिकलने सुरुवातीला जर इथं आला तर 90 डिग्रीचा कोन केला असेल ते त्याचं पहिलं ऑसिलेशन असेल. एकदा फेरी पूर्ण करून इथं आला असं गृहित धरलं तर 360 अधिक 90 म्हणजे दुसरं ऑसिलेशनमधलं त्याचा अँगल येणार आहे, म्हणजे 360 अधिक 90 आणि मग तो एक्स्ट्रीम पोझिशनला असेल. सपोज अ पार्टिकल इज ॲट पोझिशन क्यू. आता या क्यू पोझिशनजवळ तुमचा पार्टिकल प्रेझेंट. पहिलं सायकल असेल तर त्याने 180 डिग्री अँगल कवर केला आहे, म्हणजेच पाय रॅडियन तो गेलेला आहे. जर त्याने पहिलं एक पूर्ण करून परत इथपर्यंत आला असेल तर 360 अधिक 180 म्हणजेच 2 पाय अधिक पाय म्हणजेच 3 पायवर तो आलेला असणार आहे. आणि ही जी पोझिशन असेल ती परत मेन पोझिशन. सो फेज अँगल थीटा इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री और पाय रॅडियन. During first oscillation, particle is at mean position and moving to the negative direction. जर त्याने एक ऑसिलेशन पूर्ण केलं असेल आणि परत 180 पुढं आलं असेल तर फेज अँगल इज 360 प्लस 180, दॅट इज 2 पाय प्लस पाय, दॅट इज 3 पाय रेडियन. ड्युरिंग सेकंड ऑसिलेशन पर्टिकल इज ॲट मेन पोझिशन अँड मुव्हिंग टू दी निगेटिव्ह डायरेक्शन अँड सो ऑन, बिकॉज दिस डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन वी आर कन्सिडरिंग टू बी अ निगेटिव्ह अँड दिस अपवर्ड इज अ पॉझिटिव्ह. सो फ्रॉम दिस नाऊ इट इज स्टार्ट मुव्हिंग इन अ निगेटिव्ह डायरेक्शन अँड रिचेस टू दी न्यू पॉईंट, से एफ पॉईंट. इन फर्स्ट ऑसिलेशन 90 90 90, दॅट इज 270. सो फोर्थ केस, फेज अँगल 270 डिग्री और 3 पाय बाय 2 रेडियन. ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट ऑसिलेशन पार्टिकल इज ॲट निगेटिव एक्स्ट्रीम पोझिशन. वेन इट कम्प्लीट वन डायरेक्शन वन रोटेशन अँड अगेन रिचेस ॲट दिस पॉईंट, देन 360 प्लस 270 और 2 पाय प्लस 3 पाय बाय 2 रेडियन. ड्यूरिंग सेकंड ऑसिलेशन पार्टिकल इज ॲट निगेटिव एक्स्ट्रीम पोझिशन.